This video discusses the priming of DNA replication. Let's begin by confirming what we know about DNA replication. We know that DNA polymerase cannot initiate synthesis on its own. It must bind to a primer that is annealed to the template strand and elongate the primer by adding nucleotides to its 3' end. Before we discuss the synthesis of the leading and lagging strands, let's define a few key terms. DNA synthesis by DNA polymerase always proceeds in the 5' to 3' direction, adding nucleotides to the 3' end of a growing strand. At the replication fork, the two template strands are anti-parallel, which means that one strand is oriented 5' to 3', and the other is 3' to 5'. This creates a challenge, as DNA polymerase can only synthesize continuously along the 3' to 5' template strand, which becomes the leading strand. On the other hand, the 5' to 3' template strand must be synthesized discontinuously because DNA polymerase must work in short sections away from the replication fork. This results in the formation of Okazaki fragments on what becomes the lagging strand, with each fragment initiated by its own RNA primer. For the leading strand, a single primer is needed for continuous synthesis, and this primer is synthesized at the origin of replication. For the lagging strand, multiple primers are required for discontinuous synthesis, with each Okazaki fragment starting from its own primer. Here is a quick overview of Okazaki primer synthesis. Primase is a specialized RNA polymerase that initiates the synthesis of RNA primers. Unlike DNA polymerases, which require a primer to begin synthesis, RNA polymerases, like primase, can anneal directly to a DNA template and start synthesizing a complementary RNA strand without the need for a primer. RNA polymerase initiates synthesis, so primers are entirely made of RNA in prokaryotes or primarily RNA in eukaryotes. As a result, RNA primers must then be excised and replaced by DNA. Let's look at the DNA primase in bacteria. It's a single protein called DNA G that contains three functional domains. The N-terminus zinc binding domain is responsible for the interaction of DNA G with DNA. In the middle part of the protein, there is an RNA polymerase domain that is responsible for the synthesis of RNA. At the carboxy end of the primase, there is a helicase binding domain that unwinds the DNA double helix. Now let's take a closer look at the synthesis of a primer. We have a single strand of DNA with an Okazaki fragment on the right side that has already been made. DNA G, the primase, will bind on the left side and be responsible for the synthesis of a new primer. Then, the primase will dissociate from its template, and the Okazaki fragment will be made by the elongation of the primer by DNA polymerase 3. This leads to the formation of an Okazaki fragment that is between 1,000 and 2,000 bases in length. The elongation of this Okazaki fragment will stop when the DNA polymerase reaches the previous Okazaki fragment that's displayed on the right side. Okazaki fragments contain an RNA sequence at 5' linked to a DNA sequence at its 3' end. Therefore, the RNA portion of the Okazaki fragment must be removed and replaced by a DNA sequence. The RNA part of the previous Okazaki fragment on the right is removed and digested by an RNase, which results in a gap that is filled by DNA polymerase and which elongates the newly formed Okazaki fragment. Once the gap is filled, the new Okazaki fragment on the left and the pre-existing one on the right are then ligated by a phosphodiester linkage. This ligation is then catalyzed by an enzyme called ligase. Let's take a closer look at the removal of the RNA primer. The new elongating Okazaki fragment is on the right, and the pre-existing Okazaki fragment is on the left. The RNA portion of the pre-existing Okazaki fragment is shown in green. RNase H is an enzyme that digests the RNA primer, which leaves only one ribonucleotide at the 5' end of the primer. A second enzyme with 5' exonuclease activity removes this remaining ribonucleotide. The gap left by the excision of the RNA must be filled by elongating the new Okazaki fragment. In bacteria, this elongation is catalyzed by DNA polymerase 1, while in eukaryotes, it's performed by DNA polymerase delta. After the gap is filled, there remains a nick, or a small cut, due to the absence of a phosphodiester linkage between the new and pre-existing Okazaki fragments. This small nick is sealed by DNA ligase, which completes the process of DNA replication. In eukaryotes, RNA primase is a multiprotein complex. The complex includes two main polymerases, an RNA polymerase called P48 and the DNA polymerase alpha, also called P180. Alongside these polymerases, regulatory proteins P70 and P58 are also integral components of the complex. Structurally, the primer is chimeric, which means it comprises both RNA and DNA segments. The 5' region of the primer, which is pivotal in initiating replication, consists of approximately 10 ribonucleotides that are synthesized by the RNA polymerase P48. In contrast, the 3' region of the primer, which is synthesized by DNA polymerase alpha, consists of 20 to 30 deoxyribonucleotides. This chimeric nature ensures efficient and accurate initiation of DNA replication in eukaryotic cells. Let's look at the synthesis of an Okazaki fragment. If we have a pre-existing Okazaki fragment on the right, the DNA primase will bind to single-stranded DNA on the left side. The P48 component of the primase will first synthesize the RNA portion of the primer. Then, DNA polymerase alpha will take over and synthesize the DNA portion of the primer. Once the primer is made, the primase dissociates from its template, and DNA polymerase delta will elongate this chimeric primer. The size of an Okazaki fragment in eukaryotes is about 100 to 200 bases. DNA polymerase delta will elongate the primer until the Okazaki fragment reaches the pre-existing Okazaki fragment. Finally, as described before, the RNA portion of the primer is replaced, the gap is filled by polymerase delta, and DNA ligase seals the nick between the pre-existing and the newly synthesized Okazaki fragment. Now, what happens at the end of replication? This issue is known as the end-replication problem. Let's take a closer look. In our chromosomes, the leading strand's template is fully replicated until the end of the chromosome. However, the issue lies with the lagging strand template, as we can see here. In consequent replication cycles, this problem becomes more pronounced because the lagging strand cannot be fully replicated at the very end. In subsequent replication cycles, this problem becomes more pronounced because the lagging strand cannot be fully replicated at the very end. As a result, with each round of replication, the chromosome gradually shortens, potentially leading to the loss of essential genetic information over time. Telomerase is an RNA protein complex that binds to the repetitive sequences at the ends of chromosomes, known as telomeres. The RNA component of telomerase serves as a template for adding additional telomere sequences to the 3' end of the lagging strand template. This extends the template strand, which allows DNA polymerase to complete replication without losing genetic material. In this way, telomerase ensures that the ends of chromosomes are fully replicated, which prevents the progressive shortening of chromosomes after each cell division and maintains genomic integrity. The enzyme telomerase, which contains an RNA template, binds to the overhanging end of the telomere, the repetitive DNA sequence at the end of chromosomes. Using its built-in RNA template, telomerase extends the leading strand by adding repetitive nucleotide sequences to the telomere's 3' end. Telomerase shifts along the newly extended strand, repeating the extension process multiple times to elongate the telomere further. Once the leading strand is extended, normal DNA replication machinery, like primase and DNA polymerase, fills in the complementary lagging strand, stabilizing the telomere and preventing chromosome degradation. In conclusion, a primer plays a critical role in DNA replication by initiating the synthesis of the leading strand and each Okazaki fragment on the lagging strand. Prokaryotes utilize primase, a DNA-dependent RNA polymerase, to synthesize an RNA primer. Conversely, eukaryotes employ a complex that comprises DNA-dependent RNA polymerase for RNA synthesis and DNA polymerase for DNA synthesis, which results in the formation of an RNA-DNA chimeric primer. The discontinuous synthesis of the lagging strand poses a risk of losing genetic material, which telomerase mitigates in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. This specialized enzyme ensures genomic integrity by maintaining telomere length, which prevents the progressive shortening of chromosomes during DNA replication.